welcome, I would say inaugural, I did one of these before, but I kind of want to start doing these on a more regular basis, to Behind the Tech. So the first thing I want to dig into is a recent box I built for Zoom ISO. And so this is super geeky. So for anybody that doesn't know me, I'm a video production person and have been doing live streaming and virtual production for a while now. One of the products that we're super excited about is Zoom ISO. And Zoom ISO allows us to take some baseband video, I'd say baseband video, it's actually more just SDI video, straight out of a DeckLink card and up to four outputs, or it could be more depending on what your DeckLink is. So kind of wanted to go through one of the racks I just built. Super excited about this. So let's go ahead and take a look. I'm gonna switch to sort of the internal guts here. So one of the things you can see is, this is pretty amazing in the fact that you can cram all of this. Now, this is a Sonitech one rack unit enclosure. These are amazing. Honestly, we have several of these, and it's a game changer. This is a M1 Mac Mini, not an M2, but a M1 Mac Mini. Now, in this configuration, this is the DeckLink card back here. It's capable of, in this case, the four outputs. Actually, there's one input that is sync, and then the four are either inputs or outputs, depending on how we have them configured. Again, there's a lot crammed into here, and I'm gonna go through this. This is the part of the Sonitech box, and what this is a Thunderbolt card, and it allows for the Thunderbolt out of the Mac Mini to be controlling this DeckLink card. Now, below this, there's actually another slot. And so I'm gonna go ahead and sort of raise this up for you folks. And this card right here is actually a USB card. And I chose to do this because this is gonna be installed in a rack that has multiple devices that we need to configure and control. So again, let me go that way. And you can see it is a USB card. Two USB-Cs and three USB, well, essentially USB-As is what they're referred to. A few other things. Now, this little thing right here, this is basically a Govee, it's a temperature. I kind of want to monitor and kind of see, it's just Bluetooth. I'm going to use my phone just to kind of see what the temperature looks like. This box is a HDMI splitter off of USB-C. Okay, so there's where we get interesting, or this is where we start to get a little interesting. Now, it's not the best, but you can actually see, it's a little out of focus. Let me see if I can focus the camera here. Focus up, please. See if I can focus. There we go. You can actually see there's one. This has been added, this HDMI right here. And then there's a second one right there. And that right there, that HDMI is part of the unit. And then this HDMI is actually added. And the reason why I have done that is, go ahead and focus again. The reason why I've done that for, that wasn't a very good focus. There we go. So the reason why I've done this with those two HDMIs on the back is in our rack, we actually need to see the Mac Mini that's here. And it's sometimes nice to have a second output or the second output. So if we run Zoom in the two up, we actually have the ability to see both. Now, so let's just dig a little bit into the internals of this. So one of the inputs actually goes to one of the HDMIs, actually comes off of the HDMI on the Mac Mini into a bidirectional. That bidirectional is coming out of HDMI and then is fed back into the panel. Now, on the other one, the HDMI is coming off the USB-C. It's coming over to this other adapter right here. This is just a 3G HDMI to SDI. And then it is feeding back to the panel output. Well, sorry, it's feeding off of the, the splitter right here, the USB-C splitter, is feeding the other panel output. So one output comes to the 3G HDMI to SDI, and then the other one feeds the output. Now, one other thing that's in here, is a Ultra Studio. Reason why the Ultra Studio is in here, Ultra Studio recorder, the reason why that's in here is because historically, well, not historically, but if you do webcam interface, so via USB, most of the time the black level is crushed. And so what we like to do is the Zoom feed coming back, we like to have it look a little bit better. And so that's why that is in there. And again, that cable goes all the way to the outside and is looped out of this Thunderbolt right here, Thunderbolt card, the daughter card. Few other things. Now, so obviously you can see on the back, just do that again, bunch of SDIs. So deck link card, and then I have four SDIs right here. Reason why we did that is so that I can then take this module right out of the rack after unhooking everything right on there. We are essentially, everything is being converted inside of this. Now, okay, what happens if, you know, if something happens? Well, historically, what I have found is that the Blackmagic converters actually work pretty dang well. I usually don't have any issues, and we've been running these inside of our racks for a long time, and this just centralizes it all in one place. A little foam is so that when I put the lid on, you can actually see what you know, the lid will basically push these down, so these hopefully will stay put. And I've just have some Velcro underneath these, and that typically holds it down. Okay, so I'm gonna go ahead and boot this up. And let's go ahead and switch to the input here. All right, now that is, you can see that is this output, okay? That is that SDI. Now, what if I move it over? Put it to there, I'll switch again. And you can see that what that is again, it's a secondary output. Now I'm gonna move it one more over. That's the secondary output of the Mac Mini. And then the final one, we just go back to here, go back to SuperSource. The final one over here, that one is an actual input for that one. So again, with the lid completely on this system, I have, or we have, both SDI and HDMI out of the system where I can then purpose that. So the SDI goes down to our, in this case, this is in a Blackmagic 4ME Constellation HD. So that's what this one goes into. So we take one of the SDIs out of this, it goes into the Constellation. The other output then goes to a panel mount that's on the back. So again, so we have those two outputs. So we take one, goes into the Constellation HD 4ME. The other one goes into a panel that we then can feed monitors or whatever we need to do just straight out. Again, that's also why we have the HDMI for that. Now, the other one just goes down and feeds the Constellation HD straight. And then if we need to take that one, we take one of the extra outputs, again, with the Constellation HD, the 4ME, we have plenty of them. And that allows us to do that. Also, again, we have that HDMI for that. So, and again, the reason why this is looking the way it is because these four are for the Zoom ISO feeds, and then also the ones below are then to feed the sources on the both the rack as well as the Constellation HD 4ME. One other thing, the reason why, again, I'm doing this is because this will allow us, this little beast right here, allows us then to just plug and play. Everything's on the back. Click, 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 and I'm done. So I want to show you this. I'm going to go ahead and install it. I'm going to show you a little bit more on what it looks like. But again, I wanted to give you kind of a what it looks like on the inside, and then the next step will be installing it, and you can see how all of the inputs, all of the outputs for this rack unit will be very self-contained, and we're super excited about this from a standpoint of what Zoom ISO, and what this can do for just modularity.
A couple of days have now gone by, and the rack is all built back up together. I wanted to show kind of what it looks like a little bit, you know, to get an idea of how this implementation goes on. So take a look here at the back of the rack, and it's kind of hard to see because of the lacing strip, and I have some extra cooling in here also just to make sure that we're pulling the heat out. But you can certainly see over in here now that everything just comes straight out, and then it goes down into the rack where the Atom Constellation HD 4ME is. And so it just gives us a nice, really clean, you know, installation. I don't have any more converters inside of the back of the rack. They're all in there. And let me also show you an example of what the panel looks like. This is the interface panel on the back of our Atom Rack 2. And I would encourage anyone that is doing events on a regular basis to create some sort of interface panel. And it works, you know, for you, however it works. But a couple of things. One, that saves the wear and tear on the back of the connectors. Believe me, these connectors right here are a lot less expensive to pull off, put a new one on, than to have to send, for instance, the Blackmagic Atom back to Blackmagic and have them repair it. Another thing, it's just so much easier because I don't have to reach inside of this rack. It's right there. So just a real quick, you know, just an example of what this is. Again, we were talking about in the video, we were talking about earlier how I have a couple of outputs. And so let me show you this. Not labeled yet, so I do need to, and again, on top of creating an interface panel, it's important to label things. And so I made some changes right here to how the Mac interfaces. So I do need to get a actual set of labels on this. This is an actual SDI output of that monitor one. Occasionally we need to run a longer feed to some place just so we can see the computer monitor. This allows us to do that. I also could, because it is also running into the switcher, I could take one of the aux outputs and then just you know, route that to a monitor as well. HDMI 1 off of monitor 1, HDMI 2 off of monitor 2. And again, those are all on that back of that panel that I showed you earlier in the video. So these interfaces are actually coming right off of that Atom Rack, or off of the what I'm referring to as our Zoom ISO Blade server. You know, for anybody who's been around long enough to know what Blade servers were and how revolutionary they were at the time. So again, these are a couple of USB ports off the back of the Mac Mini. And these are actually a set of an in and an out off of the Mac Mini coming off of a Focusrite. It just gives us the ability to get the audio in and out a lot easier out of Zoom if we want to do it. Just a couple of other things just to note. Again, this is all of routing for, I have some Ethernet in the box, so I have some PoE. Everything's in this rack that my hand is on. And then also we have a couple of HDMIs. Those are actually tied into output 1 and 2. So it gives us outputs. And those are a couple of internal converters. I have ins and outs out of the Atom as well for audio. So yeah, that's essentially kind of what I wanted to show you. Very, very unique from a standpoint of what we're trying to build here is something that's very, very streamlined. We can just plug and play on this rack. It's easy for me to get in and just unhook these real quick, pop the screws off the front, pull the rack out. If there's anything I need to do, swap out the Mac Mini, do any internal maintenance. It's really very easy to do, and I don't have to worry about, you know, is it tied into some other converter down below. So thanks. Hope you enjoyed this video. I'm going to be doing a few more regards to Zoom, regards to what I have in my hand, which is obviously a Bitfocus Companion, and a few other things. So hope you're having a great day wherever you are.